The X Factor champ, Melanie Amaro, is fresh off of her incredible win just last month on the hit new show, which of course is a major singing competition now. The big question is, presently, what's she gonna do with the big winnings from the biggest payout in TV history? Melanie Amaro joining me right now in New York for our Showbiz Newsmaker interview. First of all, it's just great to meet you, feel your energy in the room. You seem pretty excited about everything that's going on. And let's clear something up for people who may not understand this. It's not like they handed you a suitcase with $5 million in it or just scratched you a check. It's like, here you go, have a nice day. It's a recording contract.
It is. It means that I will be in the studio working and getting my music out there. That's what that means.
But you did get a payday. You're still, you know, that, which correct. Is well-deserved, of course. My question is, because anytime anybody wins a big prize lottery or a contest or something, you want to know, what's the one big indulgence? I mean, what have you done? Have you even had a moment to go treat yourself to whether it's a new car, a pair of shoes that you would never otherwise have spent the money on?
No, not yet. I'm going to go and buy a good foot massager, though, definitely.
Well, you're because really splurging, Melanie. Go for it.
Because I really think that I need one with all the heels I've been wearing. I think that's one thing that I really need to spoil myself with.
Well, good. You deserve a foot massage or maybe one of those little foot baths you can fill up with hot water and let that do the
definitely.
Trick. Good luck with that.
Thank you.
You know, it is hard to believe that you were booted off from the show early on. I still can't get over the fact that that actually happened, and it's sort of sweet justice that you were the one who won. Let us watch the moment that changed your life.
I wanted to personally apologize to you and your family for the mistake I made.
Apology accepted.
Because you were so good. And this comes from me and the other three judges. We're going to ask you to come back and enter the competition. We want you back on the live shows.
I imagine watching that was one of the most emotional things you ever went through. Are you getting a little emotional watching it?
I am, because, oh, wow. I would never think that after that I would be here in this position right now, you know?
You get the recording contract. You've obviously been traveling around the country. You just told me this is your first time in New York. What's the most drastic way your life has changed? And trust me, it's going to change a whole lot more. But so far.
You know, the fact that now when I leave out of the room, a hotel room, or anywhere, I'm getting bombarded by people.
How crazy is that?
It's really crazy. It's so weird to like look back and like watch all these different clips of like being on the show and everything. So
is it scary at all though, realizing you've really given over your privacy and you have those people waiting around and all with good intentions? They want to meet you, feel a little bit of your energy. Does it make you a little nervous sometimes?
I don't think it makes me very nervous. It's just I'm really happy to interact with the fans and see how they feel, you know, because it lets me know that I did something right. I mean, that's why they'd want to meet and pictures.
You certainly did do something,
you know,
right.
So that makes me very happy to know that I did something to inspire some people, you know, to believe in themselves and to want to, you know, go for their dreams.
And what a neat way to have the first season of X Factor unfold. Of course, Simon was the guy working with you, and he was fully on your side after bringing you back. Another one of the judges, L.A. Reid, however, is now your boss. You got signed to L.A.'s record label. And let's face it, I don't have to tell you, some of his criticism during the competition was pretty tough. Does that make it at all awkward working with LA, or is it kind of like, all right, that's in the past, on to business?
Not at all, because to me, to be honest, I was so happy that he was honest with me every week. I would hate for him to say, you know what, you were great every week, and not say what he was actually feeling, and then I don't progress each week, or I don't make it through. So I'm glad that he told me how he was feeling, so that way each week I can use what he said and build and get bigger and bigger and bigger. So.
And you're going to get bigger and bigger and bigger. I think you have a huge future ahead. Anyway, we're just thrilled to have you here.
Thank you.
It's so great to meet you, Melanie Amaro. Best of luck with everything.
Thank you.